If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you fine, wanna have a good time, then like, comment, and subscribe. Hey, what's up, YouTube? And it's been a while. I kind of remember, it's kind of look good. It's been a while, but, you know, yeah. So, I don't know if I should. Anyways, hair is braided. Do what you mean, if you're about to put on a wig or something. I am about to go to Chicago for an acting and modeling convention. So I have to make sure that I am looking pristine. Even though I'm only going for modeling, I'm gonna be vlogging this whole experience. I'm not really gonna get into details about, you know, me installing the wig and stuff. I'm just gonna show you guys the hair. I got this off of Amazon, you already know, cheap and unique. This is from, this just says 100% human hair. I'm not really sure what company. The company says Beauty Queen. And it's the short bob wigs, human lace closure wigs, Brazilian version hair, straight short bob lace front wig, human hair, pre-plucked with baby hair, straight bob, 4x4 lace front wig for black women. Made in China. Okay, so comes in this bag. It came with the water bottle. I actually might keep this bag. It seems like it's gonna be pretty durable. A wig cap. It's a black wig cap, but I don't know. Yeah. And this is the hair. It came wrapped up in the netting. Of course, it has a wig care guide. We ain't gonna be needing that. Okay. So this is the wig. It's a cute little bob. It's not too short, but it's not too long because I don't like when my hair is too long, especially if I'm trying to make it look natural. And this is the 4x4 lace. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and install the wig. You guys have seen me install a wig before. I'm not an expert. I'm not even a hairstylist. I just try to save money and I do what I can. But yeah. So I'll be back when it's time for me to do something else. Okay, bye. Okay, so I just left Staples. I had to print out 100 copies of my resume. It was quick, and I'm glad because I have a wax appointment at 3:15. Currently it is 1:45, and I need to get my nails done, but it shouldn't take long. I'm only getting a basic manicure, and I had literally an hour to get a manicure. Hopefully it does not take more than an hour, because 2:45 I gotta go. Like, I gotta get out of there if I'm gonna try to make it to my wax appointment on time, because man. But if I am able to get a manicure and then go get my wax done, I still gonna have to get my feet done, and I can do that probably next to my wax appointment because they have a nail salon there. And that's probably gonna be the plan. And then after I get my feet done, if that happens, I'm gonna need to go by the beauty supply store because I need some more concealer, and I still need to, I think there's something else I need to do, but I can't remember. But if I think beauty supply store is the only thing I need to do while I'm out, and I get home, I gotta pack and clean my makeup brushes so I can be prepared for the weekend. But yeah, so I'm gonna get my nails done. Hopefully, you know, it don't take forever. Y'all might think I've been gone for like 30-45 minutes, but in reality, y'all, this woman did my nails so fast. Like, I got in there about like 1:47 and I got out at 2:08. 2:08. I'm like, Lord, this woman has some talent, and she did it. Okay, see, my battery was tripping. But, and she did it with, like, so much ease. She literally did everything I asked for. Like, I'm so happy I got extra time. Even though I was in a car, like, scrolling on Instagram for, like, 10 minutes. But now I can go to the Beauty Supply store and get my makeup before I get my wax done. So, yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. These are my nails, by the way. Nice, short, cute, simple. All right.
Bye. What's up, beautiful people? You think I look crazy right now? It's because I do. I'm about to get ready for registration. It's really, honestly, quick. I believe, unless my agency wants to do whatever, pep talk or whatever, but it's literally just registration, and that's the only thing I have to do today. So I'm gonna throw on some light makeup, put some heat to my wig, and a cute little outfit. I just did my toes. So hopefully, you know, it's quick because I am tired. I'm exhausted. But yeah, I'm going to do my makeup, and I'm gonna get back to you guys once I do that and get all dolled up. Hey guys. So they changed the time for us to meet from 7 to 7:30. So now I'm just chilling. I got about 20 more minutes before I gotta go down there. I'm already not feeling the stress of it all. Like, I'm not even nervous about the competitions. It's just getting through it all with ease. That's the only thing that's like kind of like just tripping me out right now, is trying to maintain my sanity. So hopefully I have more time. What is that? I have more time tomorrow to get ready, so I gotta be mindful of what. I can't be looking out, being looking relaxed out here. Look. So I'm gonna just wait these next 20 minutes, be productive, because I didn't get a chance to put an hour to my hair. So wait the next 20 minutes and then we'll see what happens. Hey guys, so right now I'm getting ready for orientation. I'm just putting some curls to my head. But yesterday really just was a briefer, and we picked up like our new comp cards and stuff. And that's pretty much it. Tell us about what to expect. Hair and makeup services, but we don't, I don't use those. But yeah, I'm getting ready for orientation. I'm gonna head down there in about 10 to 15 minutes, so hopefully I'll be done curling my hair by then. So yeah, I'm not really sure if there's any much to film today. I mean, I could try to like film a little bit of the orientation, but I feel like we're gonna be living up to this. Honestly, it's gonna be like, this is informational. Look at them girls popping. Yes, shorty. Yes, shorty. Okay, but yeah, so that's it for right now. I'm gonna check in with you guys later and see how everything goes.
The second day was nothing but workshops, which was just to help us perform better in our showcases. But my first showcase was the photo movement showcase. I got my dress from Fashion Nova. And during the photo movement showcase, we're taking just two pictures, nothing more. One headshot picture and one full body picture. So the first pose you saw me do was a full body picture. And the second pose, I did the turnaround with the look over the shoulder. I knew most girls would be putting their hands in their hair or putting their hands on their hip. I wanted to be different. The second showcase I did was a runway showcase. I got my dress from Pretty Little Thing. And the runway showcase is a T-formation walk. We just go interstage left. We pose at the beginning. We walk down the runway. No turns, no twists, nothing. We pose at the end. And then we turn around, go back the same way we came. Pose again, and exit off stage right. Just a simple, generic running walk. They didn't want us to do too much because they wanted us to show off our walk. The third showcase was swimsuit. Got my swimsuit from Pretty Little Thing as well. And during this one, we did something a little different. So instead of turning around and go back, we just walked off the front of the stage because they didn't want us to worry about being revealed for our backside. However, we did have the option to show our backside during the walk. It was optional, and of course, you know, I did it. Had to. But yeah, that was it.
Okay, hey guys. So it's been a long event day. I am about to get ready to go. Oh my gosh, I missed the button. Ready to go meet the, well, I have a meeting, and then after the meeting, I get to do a meet and greet with the scouts and agents. So if you made it this far in this video, you've probably already seen me perform in the areas that I was performing in showcases. So now we have to go to a mandatory meeting, and then after the meeting, we have a scout meet and greet. Super excited, I get to give out my resume. And basically, you know, just brag about myself for once. So, yeah, I'm excited. I think I did good in my showcases. And I'm really excited to see where this can go. So, I'm just about to get all dolled up. I'm about to fix up my makeup a little bit. Because I've been sitting in it for 5 hours now because I haven't done anything. Add some lip gloss, and I think I'll be good to go. So, if there's anything I need to update you guys on, you know, I definitely will. Oh, I guess I'll show you my comp cards and headshots that I got. They're new, so you guys haven't seen them yet. But yeah, I'll update you guys as we go along. Alright, this is. Hey guys, you see I am back home. That means that the showcase is over. By the time you get to this video, at this point in time, or however I'm supposed to say it, you've already seen all my showcases and the whole thing is over. So after I competed in my 3 showcases, the very last day of before I get to the last day, the day of the showcases, I have a chance to meet and greet with all the agents and scouts. So just because I meet and greet with them doesn't mean that it solidifies me getting signed with them or me getting a call back. This is just an opportunity to learn what each agency do. Maybe put your face out there and make some connections, but it's not going to make or break your opportunity, because you can't get to all the agents in that little bit of time we had, especially with there being 150 of us there trying to get a contract. So it wasn't possible to visit every single place. However, visiting some places can help you make and build connections. It doesn't hurt your chances of you getting a call back, because at that point they already have a list of people that they want to call back. Meeting with them means that even if you're not on the list, maybe they like your personality, maybe they'll reconsider and add you on the list. But the list of people that already been on the stage and that they've watched, they're already on their list of callbacks. So even if you didn't get a chance to meet with them, you'll be able to meet with them during callbacks. So after the meet and greet is over, the next day, we had a closing ceremony. It was beautiful. People won scholarships and awards. It was a very lovely ceremony. And after the ceremony, we were able to get a list of our callbacks. So I am happy to share that your girl had gotten 5 callbacks. And most of them were for my dream agencies I've been wanting to work with for my entire life. I am not gonna say nothing just yet of which agencies that called me back, because I want to make that a separate video once I meet with them, contact them, and solidify that I will sign with them. So I will not be naming names of agencies that called me back. However, I did get 5 callbacks. I'm very grateful. I'm very happy. Even if I didn't get 10, 12, 13, it doesn't matter. I went there only for modeling, and I could have gone there for acting and modeling, but I wanted to focus on the thing that I was most passionate about, which was modeling, and that's what I did, and I got the callbacks that I wanted. Even if I got 2, if it was ones I wanted, I was just extremely grateful. And I'm just waiting for just the future, I guess, and see where that takes me. My mother agent will help me, basically. My mother decided to call in my name and yell my name while I was filming. But my mother agent basically will help me decide which agents to go with, even though in my head,
already know which one I'm gonna go with, but they're just gonna help me go through the process of signing with them just to make sure that everything is in my favor. But just a few things, because the video is already pretty long enough. I'm gonna show you guys my comp cards and headshots that I didn't get a chance to show you when I was getting ready for callbacks. So this is my headshot. This is my headshot, and on the back of it, I'll put this up, is my resume. So they were able to see my resume and headshot, but I also had comp cards. And these are my comp cards. It's the same picture on the front. It has my name on it. But on the back is my stats and my four pictures. So that's what I was giving out to the agents and scouts that wanted to see me. I gave these out at the meet and greet, and I gave these to the scouts that I got a call back from. So those are the materials that I had. It's very important that you have comp cards and headshots or and resumes or a portfolio. Some people bring their portfolios if you want them to see what you're capable of. So I had resumes and headshots and comp cards, and I just basically just gave them all out throughout the weekend when somebody asked for it. But I'm happy. I'm really, really happy. I'm glad I went. It was a little bit stressful preparing for it, but overall, I think I did an amazing job. My whole group did an amazing job. Everyone there were so talented. And it was a very successful mission. So thank you guys for watching this video. I'll see you guys in the next video, because I will be putting out a lot of video. Okay, not a lot. A few more videos after this one. So it's definitely going to be full of posting and updates. But if you like me, if you like my content, if you want to see more of me, if you want to see more of my content, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit that post notification bell so you get notified every single time I post. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next video. Peace out, home slice.